Hello guys, myself Uman from Instrovate Technology. Today we are going to discuss about DEX language in Power BI Desktop. DEX stands for Data Analysis Expression Language. Whenever we have requirement to add new calculated field in our dataset, at the time we will be using DEX functions. Okay, using DEX function, we can add calculated column, calculated measures and new table in our existing data set. So today we will discuss what is the difference between calculated column and measures and how we can add calculated column and measure in our data set. Okay, these are few points between calculated column and measures. Measures create new calculated value. Whenever we use measures, in return we will be getting any calculated value. And when we use calculated column, in that case, we are creating a new column in our data set. A brand new column will be added using calculated column in our data set. Measures will understand filter context. Like whenever we change our filter, values will be recalculated every time whenever we change our filter. So measures are dynamic thing. And calculation, we can calculate on fly whenever we have requirement. Like first, if I am checking profit according to category, it will display profit according to my category. But whenever I change category with city, so automatically it will recalculate profit according to city. So this one is filter context. So major will understand filter context. And calculated column, they will understand row context. Like they will go row by row, it's like Excel. Okay, so in like if we have a date column and I need to calculate month name from that date column, so it will go row by row and it will give us a new column with our month name. So this is row context using calculated columns. Next one is measure can only be seen in report view. Like whenever we add measures in Power BI Desktop, we can see only in report view using a visualization. Okay, we can see result in visualization, but we cannot see measures in a column in data view or in a relationship view. But for calculated column, we can see this one in data view, report view, and in relationship view also. Okay, measures will not increase over file size as these columns are not present in our data set, so they will not increase over file size. But calculated column, they will increase over file size. Measures we cannot use for creating relationship, but calculated column we can use calculated column in creating relationship, because for creating relationship we will drag and drop our columns between two tables and we will create relationship. So as calculated column will present in our data set, so we can use calculated column in creating our relationship. Okay, these are few difference between measures and calculated columns. Now I will switch to my Power BI Desktop and we will add calculated column and measures so that it will be very clear to us that what is the difference between these two calculated fields. Now, this one is my Power BI Desktop. Here, I have already loaded these tables in my Power BI Desktop. First, let's say we'll switch to our data view so that we can see what information is present in these tables. First one is my customer table. So in this one, I'm having all information related to my customer. And second one is my product table. As these are my normalized data set, so I have like product information in product table, customer information in customer table. So same we have return table and sales table also. Okay, so these are my four tables in my this Power BI Desktop. Now I am selecting this customer table. Okay, in customer table we are having here prefix, first name and last name. Now I want to add a calculated column using DEX formula, and I want to concatenate these three fields. Like I want to add a new full name column in my customer table. Okay, so what we need to do, we can select this new column from this modeling tab, or we can right click this customer table, and here also we have new column. So we can select from anywhere, like new column. So whenever we will select, like I will select from here. So whenever we select new column, a formula bar will appear on the top of our data set, and a blank new column will be added at the end of our table. Okay, now in this formula bar, we need to write down our DAX formula. Now our requirement is we need to concatenate these three fields. Okay, so first we need to give a name for our new calculation field. Let's say I will give it full name equal to. Now we need to use concatenate function. So start typing concatenate. Now, as our Power BI desktop, in this DAX is IntelliSense, and whenever we'll start writing, automatically we can get functions. So we will select our concatenate. It has definition also. It will join our two X strings. Select this one. Now this one is our syntax for using DAX concatenate DAX function, text1 and text2. For text1, I will take prefix. So whenever I will start writing, again it will give me option for selection. Now first text, now for comma, and for second text I will take a space, because I want space between prefix, first name and last name. Now for giving space, we need to add double quotation, close the parenthesis, and now ampersand sign, and again one more concatenate function, because here we are concatenating multiple concatenating functions using ampersand sign. Now for text1, I will take first name, and for text2, same, we will give a space, close the parenthesis, again ampersand sign, concatenate. Text1 will be over last name, comma, double quotation, and between space, close the parenthesis and enter. Okay, now you can see a new column is present with our full name. Okay, so this one is our calculated column. For calculated column, what we are doing? We are adding a new column in our data set using DAX formula. Okay, so this one is our calculated column, and this one is present in our data view. And now if we'll go in our modeling tab relationship view, here also you can see full name is present. Okay, so this one is like how we can add our calculated column in our table. Now if I will select this full name again, I can see this formula bar, and I can check what formula we have used. And if you want to change this one, again from here we can change. Okay, so this one is our calculated column. Now if I want to see this field in visualization, let's say select this, and I want to check annual income according to full name. Now you can see here annual income for customer name, full name. In the starting, like for few customers, we don't have any prefix value. That's why no prefix value was present here. But after, like you can say, these are in alphabetic manners. And whenever we have our prefix value, we can see prefix value is added in front of our first name. Okay, so this one is calculated column. Now I will add a calculated measure. Okay. Now whenever we need to add a measure, we will select this new measure from here, or same like whenever we will right click any table, here also we have this new measure. For adding our measure, let's say we'll go to data view, and first I will open this sales table. In sales table, we have order date, stock date, order number, product key, and these are different key to create relationship. And here we are having one field, order quantity. Now let's say I want to sum this order quantity. So for that purpose, I will select this new measure. Now you can see this formula bar is present here, but that blank column is not added in the end for my table. Okay, whenever we have selected this new column, at that time a new column was added at the end, but for measure no column is present. Right, now let's say for this measure I will give name sum of order quantity equal to, for this one we will use a DEX function sum. So using sum function we are adding all numbers those are present in that one column. Like if here I am using this order quantity, so it will give me sum of all values present in this selected column. Okay, first select this sum. Now for column name I need to select, so let's say I will start typing quantity. Now you can see we have two quantity, one is from our return table and second one is from sales table. So I want to sum up this sales order quantity, select this one, close the parenthesis and enter. Now you can see this new field is added here. This small icon, calculator sign icon, is present. For measures we will be having this calculator sign, okay, but that field is not present in our data view. Right, now if we'll go to our report view, and now if I want to see what value is calculated in this measure, so let's say whenever I will select this one, as by default, because this one is a measure, so by default a bar chart will present. If I want to see this value, I will select this in a table. So this is displaying me sum of order quantity. Okay, now if I will select this customer name, okay, customer name, and now order quantity, now you can see it has automatically recalculated order quantity according to our customer name. Now in place of this full name, now I will select gender. Now you can see it is displaying me values present here, like female, male, and not applicable. Now if I will change this to my occupation, now it is displaying me values, and if delete this one, so it is giving me sum of order quantity according to my occupation. Okay, so every time it is recalculating our values on the basis of our selection or filter. So this is what I have explained you in measures, that measure will be recalculated every time whenever we change our filter. Okay, so these are main difference between our calculated column and calculated measures. And measures we can use in creating some different measure also. Like now I have created this sum of order quantity. Now if I want to use this in creating any different measure, I can use this field. Like I have return also. So for if we want to calculate return rate, in that case we will calculate our sum of return quantity, and then we need to divide our sum of return quantity to our sum of total order quantity. So let's say now if I will add one more measure in our return table, so in return table I will select returns, right click and select this new measure. Now again a new formula bar is present. Now I will write here sum of returns equal to some function we are using here, and we are taking quantity, which will return quantity. Okay, and enter. Now you can see this new measure is present in our return table. Right. Now, let's say I will open this second page. Here in this new table, I want to take this one is my sum of order and this one is my sum of return. So here it is displaying me total order quantity and what is the total return quantity. Now if I want to calculate return rate, so for that purpose again I need to add a new measure. I will write a return rate. It will be sum of return. So sum of return, if I will write here like sum of return, so you can say now measures are coming here for selection. So first I need to select this sum of returns divided by sum of order quantity and now enter. Now our new measure is created. Now select this one in our same visualization. Now you can see here we have return rate also, and rate should be in percentage sign. So what we will do, select this return rate, go to this formatting option and select this percentage format. Now you can see our return rate is in percentage. Okay, so here what we have checked, like we have created our measure sum of order quantity and sum of return quantity, and then again we have used our measure in calculating some new measures, like our nested measures we have created. Okay, so these are the difference between calculated column and measures. That column will be present in our data set, they will increase the size also. And but we can sometime, if we have our table such that we don't have any common field, in that case we can add calculated column so that we can use those calculated column in creating relationships. Okay, so that is the main use. Sometime like we are creating our calculated column, and major is like most of the time we are using whenever we have our like a calculated value as a return of our calculation. Okay. So this was all about calculated column and measures. I hope this video will help you. Thank you for watching.